Hi guys, welcome to Studio Semantics. My name is Ketan. There's a little mess around. Fine. Guys, can you just confirm if you all can hear me? Quickly, please just confirm if you all can hear me. Quickly. I hope I'm live, guys. Can you just confirm, you know, if you all can hear me? And I think we are good to go ahead. Okay. Great. ठीक है. Thank you so much. अच्छा, ठीक है. Fine. I hope you all can see me also, right? And I think the screen is also visible. ठीक है. So this video is predominantly on public demand. बहुत सारे बच्चों ने request करा कि sir एक बार इस ad का D-Day strategy करा था. I've been getting a lot of messages and all that. ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं. So here I am for you all. We'll be talking about it now. So those who are joined in, kindly hit the like, फटाफट से यार, and you know we will have a lot of people joining us. So okay, so Zach D-Day strategy. ठीक है. Now okay, what you need to do basically for Zach is I recommend you all to actually divide your Zach paper in the three I would say buckets, or you know, sort of section, I would say. Now the first thing that you actually, guys, like you're getting it right, you know, because you're pretty fortunate enough to get, which is 165 minutes for Zach. So time ka koi problem nahi hai, टाइम आपके पास भर भर के है, सो डोंट वरी अबाउट द टाइम्स एट ऑल. ठीक है कि भाई मेरे पास टाइम कम होगा, नहीं, आपको भर भर के टाइम मिलेगा. यू डोंट रियली हैव टू वरी अबाउट टाइम एंड ऑल दैट. सो जस्ट डोंट इवन थिंक अबाउट इट. नाउ आई वांटेड टू काइंड ऑफ यू नो सर्कल इट अप. कैसे? सो आई विल गिव यू अ स्ट्रेटजी व्हिच इज लैप 1. ओके, लाइक वी विल टॉक अबाउट कपल ऑफ लैप्स आउट हियर. सो लैप 1 विल बी अ सर्कल, काइंड ऑफ अ सर्कल. आई होप आई कुड गेट इट करेक्ट. ठीक है, सो लैप 1 में तुम्हें करना क्या है? बेसिकली you start with anything that you are good at, like jo tumhe sahi lage to mujhse chalu karo. I would mind when you begin your paper, just keep it in mind that when you start your paper, the lap 1 says that when you begin your paper, in the lap 1 you will be taking all the low hanging fruits. Okay, I'll answer all your queries, guys, in some time. Let me get finished up with this first and then we will talk about it. Okay, fine. So lap 1 will be, you will be taking up questions which are definitely easy to do. Okay, easy question, low hanging fruits, questions which are formula driven, short formula driven, right? Questions which may not take more than 2 minutes of time. Now this is going to be your first skill. This is something I want you guys to focus a lot on when you begin for your ZAT paper. So lap 1 is going to be easy, low hanging fruits, formula, 2 minutes, right? Now which sort of questions you should be looking out, in this category. Lap 1 is going to be, if I have to give you an example, I'll put it verbal ability. Verbal ability is going to be something that you can start actually in your paper with. Again, if I'm pretty good at verbal ability, you can do that. Out of 26 questions, if you go back and do the analysis very well, or probably if you have done this earlier, jab maine kaha tha, mere khayal se you will be able to see that 14 se leke 15 questions aram se doable hote hain with around about 80 to 85% accuracy. Jahan tak accuracy ka sawal hai, ZAT mein lot of people might say that ki yaar accuracy mein problem hoti hai ZAT mein, because zyada accuracy maintain karna possible nahi hota hai. Mujhe lagta hai that is not really correct, because time aapke paas zyada hai. So if you are going with a calm and composed, you know, kind of a gesture, if you're giving yourself a time, you should be getting a good accuracy. मेरे ख्याल से 85% is a good accuracy as far as ZAT is concerned. तो accuracy का problem नहीं होगा. You have to understand that your attempts need to be controlled. If you control your attempts, your accuracy is definitely going to be good. So यहाँ पे I can talk about verbal ability. इसमें we can talk about parajumble. इसमें we can talk about close test. इसमें we can talk about questions based on assumptions, questions based on arguments. These are sitter questions. You can actually do these questions in less than a minute's time or in less than 2 minutes' time. Aram se. Parajumble, do questions straightforward aega. With the option, you can actually play with the option. There is a strategy that I showed to my students yesterday. We had 4 hours ka lecture yesterday. So that's called as a rule of maximization. I am anyway going to take a session at 8:30 tonight. I'm going to show you how do you tackle verbal. So these are the things I want you to take care of. So yahan pe aapke lab 1 mein 12 question aap pe ban jayenge. अगर आपने पिछले 5 साल का एनालिसिस किया होगा डिसीजन मेकिंग का, आई अश्योर यू एंड करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग, आई अश्योर यू 7 to 8 क्वेश्चंस आर नॉट दैट अ बिग डील एज फार एज योर डिसीजन मेकिंग इज कंसर्न विद अ गुड एक्यूरेसी. सो अगेन दीज आर द 7 to 8 क्वेश्चंस आई वांट यू टू टारगेट इन द लैप वन. नाउ इन डिसीजन मेकिंग A sure shot avoid will be quant based decision making, logical reasoning based decision making, data interpretation based decision making which is based on finance, where you have to do lot of calculations, maybe compounding ka calculation ho sakta hai, ya phir CAGR ka calculation ho sakta hai, ya maybe profit and loss ka calculation hota hai. I really don't want you to put your hands into it when you begin. Simple sibat, right? So your lab one is definitely going to be kind of something wherein you really want to kind of, you know, take lot of marks on the board, right? So it's going to be T20. Just do those questions which you are able to do. You might get 10 questions. You might get, let's say, 8-8-8. Like you might have 8-8-8 in all the domain across on an average, right? You might have let's just say 8 in VA, 8 in DM, and probably 8 in quants, right? Or you might have 9-9-9, you might have 10-10-10. It can be any permutation combination out there on the D-Day. But the last one should be this one. Now that's about your verbal. RC, you are not going to touch in the first lap. If you don't want to get screwed on D-Day, and if you really don't want to fuck your paper on the D-Day, be very blunt with you, do not touch reading comprehension. I have told this to students on CAT D-Day. I told this in my earlier strategy videos for CAT. Reading comprehension mat utao, verbal ability ko zyada attention do. People went for D-Day of CAT, they took reading comprehension, their entire paper got screwed up. I think that's more than enough to convey you my feelings, right? So please do not try to venture into reading comprehension. The level of reading comprehension of ZAT is way above CAT. People take ZAT very lightly. Oh, ZAT ye kya hai, ho hi jayega. CAT is equal to ZAT. No, you cannot do this, man. ZAT has its own reputation. It has its own LOD. So kindly respect that and then only venture into it. You want to venture into it? Only 1 or 2% people, or probably 5% of the janta, I can tell that, go for reading comprehension. But you've got to be pro in that. You've got to be so bloody pro in that. You can't say that I've been reading XYZ newspaper from last 1 year. Still, you're not anywhere. Trust me, even if you're reading a newspaper from last 1 year, you get the ZAT ka paper, you look at the ZAT ka mocks, better jab mythology, psychology, philosophy aa jayega, you'll get to your level, right? So let's not venture into that. Let's give RC a little bit respect and let's avoid it at least in lap one, because if you're not doing very well in lap one, you are actually missing out on ZAT, to be very honest, right? Now, so that's about your verbal. Moving ahead with quants. Quants may a big no for algebra, number system, base system, a big no for these chapters, because these chapters are going to be on a very high level. They're going to be on a tricky level. You can definitely go ahead with arithmetic and geometry. You can take the basic questions, which are formula oriented question. I'm not saying a lot. 2019 paper was a little tricky, but on 28, I think out of 28, if anybody was prepared very well, as far as the concepts are concerned, and as far as the formulas are concerned, you should be able to get 10 questions by default correct on a good day, I would say. Or rather, even in the worst scenario, 10 questions tumhara quants ka kahi nahi gaya. You can comment on the video, whatever I'm saying, that making sense or not. 10 questions kahi nahi gaya out of 28. Agar vaise dekha jaye to it's around about 30%. Right? So you need to kind of respect ki pehle chalo theek hai, I'll take arithmetic first. Then geometry skip karna zaruri nahi hai. Raj, mere khayal se geometry ke questions straightforward aate hai. Medium, easy to medium level ke hote hai. Mostly based on the concept, theory, should be able to do it. I'm only talking about 10 questions in the lab one. So you can understand, if we do 10 to 12 questions in verbal, mein, round about 7 to 8 questions from decision making, and let's just say round about, let's say 10 questions from your quants, your overall score, rather your overall attempt is anyway 25 plus plus. Your overall attempt is anyway 25 plus plus. Right, this is lab one. Out of 75, out of 75, getting this 25 is not that a big deal. Is not that a big deal. Now, I'm not sure how many of you have seen my ZATKA video when I told you about the 30 days plan. If you have seen that video and if you have actually done some research on it, you will be able to understand that I told you guys categorically that this is going to be the hierarchy. I use the same word, I remember. 33%, 47%, and 20%. This 33% is going to be easy. Now, this is exactly what you have to do on the ZAD D-Day. Try to find out these 30 to 33% paper, or you can put it as round figure. Yaar, 30% pakad lo, yahan pe 50% pakad lo, and 20% pakad lo. Iske bahar nahi aayega. So you now need to understand in the first 60 minutes of your lap one, you can go for 60 minutes of lap one, or you can even do anything lesser than this. It's all up to you. अगर आप ZAT के पुराने 5 साल के पेपर देखते हो, 7 साल की भी अगर आप पेपर देखते हो, you will be able to understand that out of that 75, whatever numbers were there, you can actually see around about 30 to 33% paper were actually doable. All the sections, you talk about three sections, the questions were doable. The point is that, will you be able to grab them? Will you be able to solve them? Will you be able to identify them on the D-Day? You do it, you are sorted. With 25 questions getting correct, with around about 85-90% accuracy or 80% accuracy, you are anyway shooting 90 percentile plus plus. You are anyway shooting 90 percentile plus plus. So that is going to be your lap one, when you got to be very, very cautious. Moving there, then comes your lap two. Now your lap two is going to be a little bit more time consuming. So jahan pe main lap two ke bare mein baat karunga, राइट जहां पे मैं लैब टू के बारे में बात करूंगा, लैब टू विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर डेफिनेटली गोना बी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग, क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर गोना बी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग, बट क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन थ्योरी, क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन प्रॉपर्टीज, क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन थ्योरम्स, यू नो, क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर क्वेश्चंस व्हिच विल रिक्वायर हार्डकोर कंसेप्चुअल नॉलेज, डेफिनेटली वो टाइम लेगा. सो हियर यू कैन काइंड ऑफ ब्रेक इट, यू नो, क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर गोना टेक 3 to 4 minutes. जहां तक मैं क्वांट्स की बात करूंगा, ये 10 क्वेश्चन में आप एक डेटा इंटरप्रिटेशन पकड़ सकते हो, एक डीआई डूएबल होगा ऑलवेज. सो यू शुड बी टारगेटिंग इन द सेकंड लैप, प्रोबेबली इन द सेकंड लैप यू माइट वांट टू डू वन रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन व्हिच इज श्योर शॉट डूएबल, श्योर शॉट डूएबल. वन रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन आउट ऑफ 3 or 4, व्हाटएवर इट इज, राइट, आउट ऑफ 12 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, आई बेट यू 4 क्वेश्चन ऐसे होंगे जो 10 मिनट से कम समय में आप श्योर शॉट निकाल पाओगे. So this is what you can do in the lab 2. Probably in the lab 2 for decision making, you can go for the lengthy sentences. I'm not sure whether you have seen it or not, but if you have seen decision making, there are certain questions that are quite lengthy, man. You're going to read and read. So if you are somebody, if you have seen my golden rules of decision making video, that video should help you to kind of pick up the sets very well. Then you can go for this. So again, lengthy versus quants based, DI based, LR based, permutation combination based, possibility based, you should be going for lengthy one, because lengthy ones you can skip through. You can use the opening and closing methodology and you can go ahead with the question. So lab two is going to be something wherein my time consumption is more, number of questions that I'm attempting is lesser, but having my accuracy intact. The lab one was doing the questions which are easy, sitter, low hanging fruits, identify them, fatafat, you can move to and fro, right? So there is no problem with that. So what happens is that you are pretty very much confident ki theek hai, out of all the 75 questions that are there, or like whatever 100 questions are there, I have seen all the questions which I could do on D-Day. I have not left even a single question jo mujhe aa sakta tha aur maine miss kar diya. So that thing is not going to be there, right? So you're playing really, really safe. So, jitna lap one mein apne kara, you can put lap one for 60 minutes. You can put lap two for again 60 minutes. That's 120 minutes. You are still left with 45 minutes for your lap three. I hope you're with me, right? So, lengthy ones you can go for. Lengthy ones, you might get them tricky. You might not get them tricky. So lap two ka attempt will be lesser. So, probably if you have attempted 25 questions in lap one, in lap two, if you talk about, let's just say, 4 minutes per question. I think 4 minutes is a good deal, man. If you talk about 4 minutes per question, you should be able to do 15 questions out here. You are anywhere touching 50 questions in the whole bunch. Sorry, 40 questions in the whole bunch. So 25 in the first lap and 15 questions in the second lap. You are still 40 questions that you have touched with 80% or 85% accuracy. You are now crossed 95% time. Should be fine, right? 95% should be fine to fetch a call from XLRI. Then you have lab three. Now lab three is going to be a lab which is going to be a very short, very short. This should not be more than 40 to 45 minutes. Now this is going to be a really, really technical thing. Yahan pe you will be taking those questions wherein you might just take 10 minutes per question. Here you might get 10 minutes per question. You might want to take one RC. You might want to take questions based on number system, algebra, which are super duper time consuming, but that's your forte. You can nail it. It's just that you avoided them during lab one and lab two. You picked them up in lab three. Your lab three is always going to be score optimization strategy. Score optimization. It means in the 40 next minutes, I won't mind doing five questions, or I won't mind doing three questions and getting plus three. Because this plus three in the end would matter a lot. And by the time you are done with lab two, in 120 minutes, you have seen all the questions. You know the level of difficulty. You know now where do you stand in the paper. You now know how many questions you have left, which has 0.10 ka negative marking. Now you also know that what is your overall accuracy. Then in this lab, you can probably attempt a little bit of more tukkas. And here you can understand in the lab three that you really have to go for tukka, or you can go for actually genuine attempt. Lab three in C2C Mentors, we give it an acronym. This is the acronym that we give in C2C Mentors for this score optimization strategy. In Hindi, this is called as apni apni bachav andolan. Iska matlab, you have to save your, or rather you have to take care of, you know what I mean, right? So your last lap is going to be score optimization. So slot one, all the easy questions doable. All the easy questions, those who could do, you've done with it. Lab two, something that might take 10 minutes or something that might take 5 to 6 minutes per question. Hardcore conceptual based, you have done that. And in lab three, you just have to take care of your score optimization. As simple as that. Right? Some YouTubers are saying go for 30 tukkas. I don't want to comment on that. 30 tukkas karna hai, 25 tukkas karna hai. Wo aap dekh lo. I am only talking about those who have studied very well, those who have worked hard for Zach. I wanted to divide your paper in three level, and I bloody bet anything on it. You apply this strategy of lab three, right? And this strategy, aap maul de do, aaj de do, kal de do. I can guarantee you, aapka score optimized hoga. Agar aapne level of difficulty thoda badh gaya, and if you are cautious enough to reduce your attempts and focus more on accuracy, this strategy will definitely give you a delta of round about 4 to 5 marks. Beta 4 to 5 marks in that can take you round about 20 percentile plus. Because this is what you need to understand. The intensity of that is pretty high. You get 1 to 2 questions correct, you are jumping 10% plus. Okay, you are jumping 10% plus. So that's what you need to understand. And for heaven's sake, those who do not understand anything about the aptitude exam, better you need to understand tukka is a liberty that has been given to you. But if you talk to people, those who have done very well in the exam, they will never go for tukka. Right? People, those who are good at aptitude, people, those who understand the seriousness of getting into a good B school, these people will not go for tukka. They'll reduce their attempts, they'll increase their accuracy, but they'll not do a shit of something called as tukka. Snap mein kuch bada tukka maro yaar, kuch farak nahi penda wahan pe, right? But yahan tak zat ka sawal hai, beta isme thoda tough hoga. So guys, you need to understand, you got to be very choosy as far as your questions are concerned. Do not attempt questions bhar bhar ke. It is okay to leave certain questions because 0.10 you can afford. You cannot afford 0.25. So all the tukka janta out there, beta, thoda sa samajh lo. You cannot take ZAT the way you have taken SNAP or CAT. It's a different exam altogether. It has its own reputation. Thoda respect karo usko. Yaar, GK ke liye kuch zyada bolu kya nahi. If you are a C2C ka bachcha, everything is uploaded on the dashboard. But again, GK is going to be static plus current affairs. Actually, common stuff, personality, they'll talk about authors, they'll talk about books, they'll talk about some organizations. So just take care of that. Mere khayal se GK matter karta bhi nahi hai. It's just that the XLR will look into it if there is a tie or something like that, right? So there is no negative marking for GK, I guess. I hope this helps. And passive mock dena jitna ho sake utna agle 2-3 din, but ZAT mein tukka mat marna, theek hai? Don't take ZAT lightly. If you are a good student, if you attempt well, if you attempt decent number with good accuracy, you will be able to get good fruits out of it. Kitna number chahiye ya fir kitna score aayega beta, wo zamana badal gaya jahan pe main keh sakta tha ki aap itna karo. आपका हो जाएगा. मेरे ख्याल से आप पहले लेवल ऑफ डिफिकल्टी गॉच करो. लेवल ऑफ डिफिकल्टी के ऊपर आपको पता चलेगा क्या करना है. मेरे ख्याल से 35 से लेके 40 का स्कोर इज अ गुड स्कोर टू फेच यू राउंड अबाउट 99 परसेंटाइल. बट अगेन कंडीशंस अप्लाई. पेपर अगर ज्यादा टफ आ गया तो मेरे ख्याल से ये 30 पे भी आ सकता है, पेपर अगर ज्यादा इजी आ गया तो ये शायद से 45 पे भी आ सकता है, सिंपल सी बात। सो मेरे ख्याल से ये गलत बात है ये अभी से सोचना कि मैं कितना अटेम्प्ट करूं मैं कितना अटेम्प्ट नहीं करूं। आपको आपका माइंड ब्लैंक रखना है, आपको एग्जाम के पहले सोचना ही नहीं है। ये मैंने कैट में भी बोला था, कैट में बच्चों ने जाके डीआई में 20-20 21-21 क्वेश्चन मारे, वर्बल में 20-20 क्वेश्चन मारे, जब आंसर की हाथ में आया तो पता चला पूरा लाल 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 रेड रेड पूरा होली चल रहा है आंसर की में, पूरा होली मतलब वो हिंदी वाला पूरा कलरफुल सब रेड 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 रेड। यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? सो दिस इज समथिंग यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड, यू कैन मार्क इट अ लॉट, यू गॉट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द लेवल ऑफ डिफिकल्टी ऑफ द पेपर, हाउ मेनी क्वेश्चंस आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड। बट अगेन अगेन हैविंग सेड एवरीथिंग, इन अ वर्स्ट सिचुएशन इन अ गुड सिचुएशन यू विल बी एबल टू सी 30% पेपर और 30% क्वेश्चन आउट ऑफ द होल चंक, प्रिटी डूएबल। सो गिव योरसेल्फ गुड टाइम एंड दैट शुड बी डूएबल फॉर यू गाइस। तो थोड़ा 2017, 18, 19 एंड 20 का देख लेना पेपर, वैरायटी देख लेना, आपको पता चलेगा ठीक है। जीके विल बी कंसीडर्ड बाय एक्सेलर है मेरे ख्याल से, जैट के मेरिट जो मेरिट निकलता है स्कोर निकलता है उसमें जीके नहीं आता गाइस एनीवे। सो गाइस आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस, दिस इज ट्राइड एंड टेस्टेड, आई टोल्ड दिस टू माय किड्स अ वीक बैक, दिस स्ट्रेटजी आई टोल्ड माय किड्स, सीबीएसई का बच्चा लोग, आई टोल्ड देम दिस अ वीक बैक, आई बीन गेटिंग फिनोमिनल रिजल्ट्स आउट ऑफ दिस। अलोंग विद दिस यू जस्ट नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ योर क्वेश्चन सिलेक्शन, you are there in the game, you will be much better than the you know most of the bachalog out there, that's for sure. That is all about strategy. Every bloody exam nowadays is all about strategy. You got to put in your strategy very well and you're right there in the game, and that's the reason I say that there are 90% of the people, they'll help you rather than 90% of the students help 10% of the students to do well in the exam, because 90% of the people are going to screw up for sure, for sure. So, उसमें वो 10% बच्चों का फायदा होता है, because at the end of the day, it's a percentile game. It is not a percentage. So, guys, I hope that's more than enough for you. And hi, yaar, happy new year to everyone, guys. Happy new year to everyone. I wish you all the very best in this year. May you all get your dream B school. You know, work your ass off, man. Work your ass off. It's going to be next 20 years are going to be India's next 20 years. It's going to be a golden years for a country like India. There are only bloody two countries flourishing in the world now. That's India and China. We should feel fortunate enough that, you know, we are part of this country. And yeah, just work your butt off, man, and go for that. Kill it. Use these strategies very well. Yeah, understand these things, right? Unattempted and all attempted. ठीक है, वो unattempted का ज़्यादा load मत लेना. वो होने ही वाला है. अच्छे-अच्छे बच्चों का भी 15-20 questions unattempted रह ही जाता है. ठीक है, so don't worry about that. So guys, yeah, I wish you very happy new year. Do well. Yeah, do not party hard. Study bloody so hard. And once you get into a good B school, fucking party harder, man. Let people know how you enjoy, right? Let them know how you party, right? So, number one, we're gonna get a good B school, and then we're gonna do rest of the extracurricular activities. So, guys, that's it from my side. Thank you so very much for joining in. I'll be available again around about 8:30 tonight. We'll talk about verbal. That's it from my side. Bye bye, guys. Bye bye.